Hey guys, name's Fen, playing a bonus video here because the Dark Mod 2.05 was just released, and with it comes this new two-mission pack. Mission 1, a new job, which is a brand new mission, and Mission 2, which is Tears of St. Lucia, which I've already let's played. But this one is new, and despite it, you know, being marketed as your next step after the tutorial kind of thing, I figured, well, I might as well play it anyway and pretend to be a newbie, because, God, I pretty much do that all the time.
I go by many names in this city. Outlaw, rogue, thief. The few people who know me call me Corbin. My job is to acquire valuable items for the rich. Sounds easy. But these items are usually owned by someone already, someone who doesn't want to part with them. Luckily, I'm quite good at what I do. Tonight, I'm meeting someone who wants to hire me for a job. I don't know the details yet, but an associate of mine has vouched for him, and the message managed to pique my interest. I'm supposed to meet my contact in a courtyard south of Canterbury Tavern. Canterbury is popular with wealthy travelers, and it just so happens that a Lord Rothwick is staying there tonight. I'm told he has a purse full of very expensive rubies with him. I've decided to arrive in the area a little early and engage in a bit of burglary. A tavern won't have the same level of security as a private estate, and it shouldn't be too difficult to find what room Lord Rothwick is in. The guest names are in the registry. I can help myself to that purse and still meet my contact in the courtyard on time. Not bad for a night's work. I've booked a room near the tavern. The sun is down, my gear is ready, and the city awaits. It's time to begin.
I hope you like that bonus cursor in the middle of the video there. It's because I love you guys. And, okay, let's go.
The back alleys of Bridgeport. You can get almost anywhere unseen, if you know your way through the maze.
Yes, very nice title screen there with the timely tips and whatnot. Now, like I say, this may be a slight tutorial mission, but I'm just curious to see it. Is all food not works. Dark, just like the smoke of the works. And like your skin would be if you would bother to get out there, sir. But no, you just sit at home doing absolutely nothing. There's a St. Lucia true miracle, and they got some movable type going there. And there's not me because it says like age 19, or maybe it's supposed to be 29. I don't know. There's some placebo herbals, and this is not a real door. I played just a couple of minutes of this, in fact. You know, full disclosure and all. And full disclosure, I'm hoping that it's not real. I'm hoping I get to do some advanced maneuvers. Is that really not real? I guess so. Well, spoiler, you could jump up on clotheslines, in case you didn't know that. But I guess no such luck will occur over in that place. What was that? Clanging just because of my incessant jumping? Physics defying. Incredible. So, yeah, there's a clothesline there and you could jump. Ah, why not? It's a great fun game, but it's just a broadhead. Like, when the heck am I ever going to use a broadhead? Honestly. My head is narrow and thin. What do you think I am? Dibbly mangrove? No. I'm hurt instead, because I'm such an expert player that I decided to handicap myself to the tune of like 2% health. And this is to train you that you gotta stack these crates. Another thing I'm interested in seeing is just like how the mission trains you, you know? Because I guess it's supposed to do that, so pretty good so far. You look around in areas and can't find anything and you end up trying to lift the crates and do stuff. I don't know, it seems intuitive to me anyway. Alrighty.
Huh?
The city watch makes the main streets a lot riskier. Even regular citizens might raise a hue and cry if they see someone dressed like me.
The old man said the builders are harassing the girls behind the inn. Says it's bad for business.
What does he want us to do about it? Builders don't carry those hammers for decoration, you know. They'll bash your skull in right quick. And who's going to stop them? You think a church court will hang one of their own? We ain't gonna rap on the knuckles. That's what they'll get. And they'll be back on the streets by breakfast.
The city needs to put a stop to it. You let a dog roam free in the kitchen long enough, and soon he thinks he owns all the food.
Our beloved Benny. That is Benny. That's the most important thing this mission will teach you, is that that is Benny. Except he's not called that, I guess, but... Never you mind. He'll always be Benny the Sawface to me, because I just name people what I see, objects, look at, name, see. Looks like I could get over there, but I guess this isn't a climbing mission supreme, unlike behind closed doors for Thief 2. Disappointing. Oh, it's an actual paper. And also, when you read, you better be in darkness, because the Bridgeport Review. Miracle at St. Roderick's. Mill Street, February 17. Several penitents have reported a miracle at St. Roderick's Church. A statue of St. Lucia has been seen to weep tears of blood on multiple occasions. Many witnesses have reported that they have seen this with their own eyes. While the cause is not known, the faithful are certain it is a sign from the Master Builder himself. The Archbishop of Bridgeport has been called upon to confirm the miracle and plans to visit St. Roderick shortly. In the meantime, many worshippers are going to the tiny church to pray for healing and good fortune. Traders attacked by savages. Flake Bridge, November 12. A group of traders, 2 days east of Flake Bridge, were attacked by savages. Many men were slain and injured, and their goods were taken. The builder roads surrounding Flake Bridge Monastery have not been maintained or guarded for years, and attacks by tribes of savages have increased in recent months. Travelers are encouraged to avoid them, and traders to move their goods by boat. That's racist, because that's the biggest problem you've got, is racism. Also, there's some advertisements here, I guess. And there's something that'll tell you how to use water arrows and... in a flood of light, and doesn't do me any good. Telling you how to like turn lights on and off. Amazing teaching there. So I'm probably supposed to go in that front door. I'm a thief, so I'm going in the back. That's why I'm so intelligent a human being, you see? Because I go in the back of the bars. Because if you went in the front of the bars, it would be called jailbreak. And then you'd really be in trouble. You'd be placed back in jail, and then you could break out again. But sooner or later, your captors might get tired of that and place you in super jail. And that's just too surreal for any of us. Oh. I get a bad feeling about falling here, but I guess not. Really? Not even a single coin in this drunk spot? How could it even occur? I got a bad feeling about this, too. Like, I can't... I'm not going to be able to get back up here, am I? I mean, seriously, I got to meet your contact in the southeast corner. This sounds like it's going to the southeast corner. I don't know. Or it's just the start, maybe? Hopefully not. No, it isn't. Good. So I don't know how big this mission is. Feels like I should have ropes. I don't know, man. Can I get back up there? Feels like I can't, man. Alright, never mind. I'm gonna explore the streets first. Never mind all of that stuff I said about not going in through the front and all that other innuendo. Never you mind. I've decided to be a clean and tidy person, because otherwise, how would I survive in this brave new world of censoring everybody? Ho ho! And giving the poor not any money, like I said in that one video, which was supposed to be some sort of comment on my own self, but ended up sounding a little sketch, so, yeah, whatever. Oh, yeah, by the way, there's... I don't even know if this is a tavern. Maybe not. I mean, maybe these guys were just... Yeah, it's not. It's just like, hey, diggity, there's some barrels. How's goes it?
Dog meat.
Oh, no. And see, if I had, like, anything at all worthy of anything, I could get this guy off my back. But okay, that makes a bit more sense, I suppose. You know, explore the place before you go stampeding directly... into the clip. clips for your hair. Don't put your hair in clips. It will cause you to get kicked off of YouTube for being advertiser inappropriate. Okay?
Noise?
You take it from me. Oh, yeah, but that guy can't knock him out. So I guess, I mean, I already know this stuff, so I'm not a good judge of how well it teaches you, but it seems to be, like, okay at presenting elements one after another to sort of get you accustomed
There's
to them.
There's the tavern. That garden fund is a problem. I'll either need to distract him or find another way in.
This ends now. Pfft,
didn't realize you were going to turn there, sir. Okay, find another way in. So perhaps that back alley would be some sort of way in. I don't know, man, as I don't have a map. Seems a little underprepared to me. But hell, what do I know about being a thief? Nothing. You have a loot on you? Guess I haven't been introduced to that quality yet. Too bad. See, the one time I'm looking up, it's like, oh, you can't. Well, End and Co. Yeah, I should. Yeah. Like, it seems like I could climb it there, but never mind. I'm just gonna go through this other alley and make the brash and rash assumption that it will take me eventually where I wish to go. Okay, okay. Climbing is pretty fantastic. Oh, yeah. And you can even break your feet, which is another bonus. What the hell am I doing? Okay. Yeah, seriously. I love breaking my feet. I do it every time I walk up the stairs. It's extremely satisfying in a highly inappropriate and erotically charged fashion. This is a lark. I know. However, just a blacksmith, or it's the tavern. Guess my sense of distance wasn't so good. Okay, search Lord Rothswick's room for the rubies. But I'm not going to, because guess what? My style is to just do everything else first, except the alley I'm supposed to meet my contact is probably here. So maybe this mission isn't that big. I don't know. But it seems to be fairly good looking. Nice, gritty old city. Very good introduction to the general world. Dropping a bunch of names, which is the same as just writing down a bunch of names. But you can say, name droppers! And stuff like that. Also, had I any skill at all, I could have done that. Also, here's an introduction to one of my concepts. I call it scouting time! Oh, that was a leaf, not a gold thing. Okay, so this... Oh, this is the alley I'm probably supposed to meet my car. Okay, never mind that then. It's time to stop blabbling and get to the glabbling. Which is not an English word. So, you know, it's too bad. You were already agreed by contract and by law to watch this entire video start to finish, so there's nothing you can do. It's a steam engine. Like a real accurate steam engine with the balls out sort of thing. Yeah, which I learned somewhere that balls out actually means these steam engine balls out, which is like a speed regulator, because the more they go out, the more they slow down. It's actually quite fascinating. If you're into such sort of razor-focused, aspie interests, such as I, which is why I'm able to succeed at these incredible monologue-type videos, because all I do is talk, and it runs an elevator. I guess, well, how else would you run an elevator? Sure. However.
Oh no!
Oh no! One should probably.
Ow! Please, just let me go.
Hello, lady. Hey, I'm not a hammer, so I'm allowed to harass you, okay? That's how you knock someone out. And after you've knocked them out, well, you can just gently place them in a corner and make sure it's gently, because you don't want to have somebody making accusations. I mean, in these modern times when, you know, you can't ever hear the word. Oh, that was horrible. I'm gonna cut that part out. Yeah, that's right. Anyways, one should always check for loot underneath these elevators because you never know. Because you never know. But it wasn't the case this time. But there's some old newspapers, surely equally as valuable. Okay. 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 Steam just burns the boards and catches fire. I love this. This is amazing looking. It's like you could stick that at a car and call it a car. Probably have to learn these dudes what a car even is. Horrid. Is this that hogwort medicine? No, it's some sort of googe mixture. Well, I don't have the googe, fortunately. So, ladies, you don't have to worry about nothing.
Hey, did you see the Moorish guards they have protecting the vizier? I wonder what those curved swords would be like in a fight.
I heard those swords are just for show. They say the Moors can use magic to summon genies and wind and stuff.
They fight by summoning genies? What do they do, huh? Rubber lamp?
And winds. They can summon really, really strong winds.
Oh, sure. Better make sure the washer wench doesn't pick a fight with one on laundry day, then.
Cheeky git.
I didn't catch what they were talking about as I was blabbling. You're a supermodel, I'm a supermodel, so our relationship will be perfect and boring, okay? Great. And make sure to not have any depth of communication either, because that would probably make it a bad story, too.
How's your shift?
Could be worse.
Nah.
Yeah, I can't light it.
No, you saw it from all the way over there. I mean, you can't because you're sitting all the way over there, man. Oops, wrong button. That can sometimes screw you right up. Don't know why I'm talking as if anybody watching this is not completely familiar with me in the first place, but hey.
Why can't we get some decent lights around here?
Indeed. Hang on.
Huh?
Oh, no.
I thought I saw something move.
Eh, well, perhaps you did. Oh, that's not a purse either. Yeah, I'm just giving an invisible hand puppet show here. It's the latest in technology. Don't y'all mind it. Sometimes you got to stand up to read these books. You see what I mean? You can't.
There's room for improvement.
Always.
Look, over there.
I don't have enough water arrows for this crap. Come on.
Is someone putting those out?
If I light it, it'll just keep going out.
All right. Oh, this is just the guest book. Okay.
I heard something.
So, John Smith, room 4, Lord Rothwick. There's only 5 rooms. Expensive wine, incense burner, use of safe. Fine. So this is kind of like the Deadly Shadows tutorial mission, except without blue stuff every which way. Right, so that's the front entrance. It's only got one door, so you know it's a cheap bar.
Could be worse.
Huh. Funny how they're barking at each other just sitting around there. Uh-oh. And this guy's got green hat. Okay, it's a green hat, but it... Whatever. It looks a bit, you know, punkish.
What?
So, I best watch out for what? Punky Brewster there as I steal his gold that he made from selling his best-selling album, Cooked on Phonics. Also, if you're a good thief, you would close these, but if you're a thief who wants to know where he's been or annoy people on the internet, you would leave it open, okay? Lord Belhaven to host Vizier Ibrahim Saif al-Dawlah, the Vizier of Aqaba, has come to the city. Oh, he's turning the pages. Amazing. Realistic. Has come to the city to discuss greater trade between the great merchants of Bridgeport and the southern spice barons of Arabia. The Vizier is being hosted by no less than Lord Belhaven himself, a great honor to this powerful emissary from the south. Bridgeport's harbors...
Why are we using open flames in here anyway?
Already welcome many Arabian ships, more than anywhere east of Minoa, and Arabia is awkwardly an actual real-world name, but hey, never mind. Town sacked by barbarians! More racism! I'm not even gonna read this one! Better living through steam, the steamer. Yeah, I love these advertisements. This is cool. It's pretty cohesive, actually.
What was that?
It's a safe. Somebody called this Thief 4-ish in the city sections. I guess so. Was that the cash box for... No, it's... For the counter, I mean. That would be a little nonsensical, but... Certainly.
Well, that's an odd noise.
Oh, you there. I want to read your stuff, but I guess... that ain't happening. So, oh, wait. This guy's room is like... No, this is the room I want. So what's with the cash box key? Like, why would he have the... Why would he have the key for the counter? Oh, well.
hospital out of business.
Perhaps he just has a really, really bad idea of where to place things for safety. Yeah. Well, whatever. Like, what's the code? What is the code? It's probably obvious and I just forgot, but just in case that's not the case, I'm gonna keep screwing around until I stumble upon the right answer. Okay, fantastic. Looks like not too much security here. Although there is one guy, he's got an eye patch though, so you know he's the best guy to have on visual duty. It's the realistic inn. When there's nobody in the room, there's nobody in the room. Dog, so don't even try. Nothing but a droopy old plant. It's all like, mangy plant.
One-eyed guard. This must be my lucky day.
Yeah. And that's what he's like, probably. Whatever I just said. It's dangerous to get to the side of a guard because they turn their head. Oh. Well, thank you, sir. There's one water arrow figuratively down the toilet. Oh. Well, thank you. I guess you're slightly tough after all. Rolf. Oh yeah, they've got names, do they? Interesting. I should go check that other body's name instead of disrespectfully just three-wheeling it all up in his face and choking his life out of the next seven generations of his brethren. What am I saying? That's the question one could ask about me anytime one wishes. Yeah. Droopy plants all up in every room, you know? This inn is consistent. Every single room gets a droopy plant, and if you don't have one, we'll be happy to replace it for you with an actual one, or with another one that isn't one. Because replacing nothing in the sense of an exchange would be an exchange with also nothing. So it's kind of weird how that works in a mathematical sense. This is why you have to go to high school and get a degree in math from high school in order to be a chamber pot cleaner. In order to do whatever I just said. Electrification kills doctor. One Dr. Cleary, a surgeon at Bellhaven Hospital, was burned horribly, resulting in his death while operating electrified devices inside the hospital. The electrification of Bellhaven Hospital, funded by Lord Bellhaven himself, was touted as a great step forward into the modern age. It seems that the modern age has claimed another victim. Dr. Cleary was a wealthy and learned man who gave up much in order to help the poor souls of Bellhaven. The hospital is accepting donations. Warren's quarantine still in effect. The Warren's district of Bridgeport remains under quarantine from a plague, the source of which appears to be the unfortunate vessel Fair Maiden, which still lies at anchor in the docks there. Though the plague appears to have run its course, killing nearly all of the district's residents, a few survived. The quarantine will remain in effect until money is found to tow the Fair Maiden out to sea and sink her. Just like AC/DC told you, probably. Oh, well, maybe the guy staying in that room is the owner of the inn. He's just like, I got nowhere to sleep. I gotta waste up a room and pay myself out of my own profits. It's just a silly concept, paying oneself. Oh, there's the incense guy. I don't know what the deal with that safe is, though. Maybe that wasn't a hotel room. Maybe that was the owner's private room and it wasn't numbered and I'm just blind or not thinking. So, they were talking about some swords. I saw something. Oh, it's just dust. Dust bunnies. Just kind of a way too normal name. Is this supposed to be an incense burner? Because it looks more like a lava lamp. But hey, what do I know? Oh, see, some people do wear weird stuff when they're sleeping, such as clothing and keys and clothing and rings. I hate this city. Soot and stench everywhere. And not only do thieves hide in the dark alleys, but they come out of the very sky. I was walking by a transmitter tower next to the tavern this morning when a damn magpie swooped down and stole a ring right out of my hand.
Pfft, the coincidences. Magpies? Again?
Rolf just stood there like a dolt as the bloody bird mocked me from up on the pipes above the street. I should get Rolf a bow. This is supposed to be a safe neighborhood, but I saw two Moors on the street outside last night. People seem to think they're here with that ambassador, but these two looked like they were up to no good. They were following a well-dressed man down the street, and they obviously didn't want him to know it. How am I supposed to feel secure with that kind of thing going on? The innkeeper has put my jewels in an iron safe in his room. He wouldn't tell me the combination. When I asked what would happen to the contents if he forgot what it was, he just laughed and said, when that happens, he goes and gets drunk at his workbench. What an odd fellow. If it weren't for the trade fair of the Inventors Guild, I wouldn't leave Braden, but the devices they had on display were a wonder to behold. Lanterns that can follow behind you and light up the street. What? Truly a marvel. 'Tis a shame Bridgeport keeps these wonders for itself. All their blueprints are in code, and any inventor that tries to leave the city is executed. I suppose Bridgeport would have fallen to her enemies long ago without those inventor machines guarding the harbor, so I cannot fault their caution. I'll be leaving in the morning and glad of it. Is he talking about those little robots, actually? Okay, get the rubies from the safe. And I need 640 gold pills. How am I going to get that? Around town, obviously, unless, of course, the rubies count for gold, which not because they're rubies. Never mind that. Yes, so I was just not paying attention with that innkeeper's room. Fine. Yeah. Realistically empty. That's one of the hallmarks of Thief and the Dark mod, is realistic rooms that are empty. It's not a problem, really. It's just a charming thing. This little pipe going up there, you could...
So, how's your shift?
Breathe in the smoke from the weeping steel, because steel weeps smoke, I'm pretty sure. All right, you guys, scouting time. You got anything on your waist? Shadows. How about you? Well, you got a sword. Not exactly what I was talking about, but... Sure. Okay, yes, the innkeeper's room. Obviously. Who the hell said that? Sounded closer than it was. So his workbench. Drunk at his workbench. Is his workbench somewhere else? Wait. Is there supposed to be a code written? Okay, maybe 1630, which, that's a table. Drunk. What? Well, a workbench might be this sort of steamy room over here. Okay, I mean, I don't know. This seems like the kind of room that might have a bench. Not sure. This looks like a bench, but workbench? What sort of work? I mean, cutting food? Looks more like a preparatory bench to me, but what do I know? This looks like a workbench. Alrighty. Is this teaching me to zoom, or what? I don't see nothing that... Oh. Oh. 162. Oh. Yeah. It teaches you everything you need to know. Man, that is cool as heck. Not that the training mission is bad at all. I've personally played through it, and... As soon as they got that crash fixed, which was fixed a very, very, very long time ago and doesn't exist anymore for years and years and years now, then it was really great. Should probably not mention that to avoid confusion, but... yeah. It's too late now, man! But yes, back in version 1.07 or something, there was a dangling pointer issue, but it's long gone now, so... okay. 672, is it? I've already forgotten. Oh. Hey. I don't think I remember anything like this. Interesting. Didn't even know you could do that, I don't think. Oh my god, that wasn't it. Fen. 162. Yeah. I'm Fen, the guy who just pulls numbers out of the air. I think I was thinking of that newspaper date and I had that mixed up in my head. Maybe there was a 7. Maybe the crossed out number was a 7. I don't know, man. I work in mysterious ways, bruh. It's the secret of my success. Okay. What was it? 593? No, I'm just kidding. Okay. 162. Oh, yeah. Still not... But it's optional, though. But... I think I might like to go for it. Also, if you're a super good thief, you would do that. Maybe even set him to 0, but I'm only a decently good thief, so it's not happening.
So, how was your night?
Well, there was that ring that I right about here. Like, let's say blah, 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 blah. The ring, the magpie. The transmitter tower next to the tavern. Up on the pipes, right. Cool. Yeah, that's just strangely similar to Mickhead's thing with the magpie stealing stuff. Well, it's got magpies in it. I mean, that's similar, right? Okay. I don't know if there's anything valuable in here. There's a whole lot of junk, and there's the top side of the droopy plate. Yeah, wilted, droopy, dead plants. Courtesy of the expensive hotel service we got up in here. Oh, yeah, yeah. Maybe that ring will finally do it. Okay, next to the tavern, a transmitter pole. All right. Pipes and a transmitter thing. Where could it be? Maybe on that side. I don't see a transmitter pole looking thing. Well, I mean, that's a lamp post. So maybe not that then. Perhaps not. Yeah, it looks like loot is just kind of nowhere. Do I see anything over there? Next to the tavern. How much far next is next? But wait, if I can't climb back up to the beginning, then how might I safely get around here, eh? Also, does that guy ever turn like normally, or is it just if he hears something? Look at it, so looks like I could get up there, but no rope arrows. What a strange thing. It doesn't want to tell you about that. Okay, can I seriously? Maybe. Oh, yeah. In fact, maybe this is even meant for you to go the other way with, so yeah. Never mind. No. Okay. Come on. There we go. Maybe not. Come to think of it, but hey. Pipes, transmitters. Ooh, amazing talk going on here. I could be a stand-up comedian with this. Transmitters, are they cardboard or are they pizza? Ha! Well, there's some pipes. There's a tree. Don't mistake a tower for a tree, yo. Honestly, that's just silly. Okay, well, there's a pipe. Next to the tavern. Well, everything's next to the tavern, but that red thing, pipe thing, does seem suspect. But I don't know. Oh, is that a transmitter tower? Like, on top of the tavern? That seems a bit off there. Like, that's not exactly the first thing you'd notice if you were trying to give your location there, but what do I know? I don't think I can do that.
Drop that weapon.
God. So I think maybe you can climb this tree somehow. At least I've got stuck up there just now, but perhaps not. Hang on, though. Hang on a goddamn second. I'm gonna save you from getting hanged in a second here, but first you gotta hang up. Ugh. Really? Really? Nah. Alright, this has gotta be it, because look at that suspicious red light and everything. Come on, magpie. Give me the stuff. I'm a human and I need it more than your dumb bird-like ass does. You're the dumbest of all birds. Read that on Wikipedia. Or did I? Alright. Yeah. Grunting noises! Jeez. Okay. This has gotta be correctamundo. That's a word you can say. May not be real, but the funny thing about words is you can say corporeal and ghost-like ones. You can say anything that has or hasn't been invented yet. All right, birdie bird. Oh. Somebody was inspired by somebody, but how could it be? It's weird. Also, that's still not... Oh, my God. I should probably just give up and admit that I'm not an expert thief like I thought I was. Boo. Unless, of course, I can climb higher somewhere. Oh, I'm so good at this, man. It's funny how you get hurt coming down here all the time. Maybe you're not supposed to, but you just kind of end up sliding, so... I don't know. I don't like to accept that I couldn't get a measly 640 goldy-gold or whatever, but... It says gold pieces. Does that literally mean gold only or total loot? Is it being loose with definitions or what? I don't know. Let's just go and meet our fence and yours, Fencemeister McGee. Oh, I'm not done, am I? Oh, I thought it was just going to end right away. Royston Court, this isn't an alley. What are you talking? Wait, what? Oh. Well, alrighty then. Perhaps I am a super world's expert thief after all. Gaining my cockiness right immediately back. Very, 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 very much magpie-like my intelligence is. I thought that was supposed to be a compliment, but perhaps not, so ignore what I said just there.
Corbin? Is that you?
If you'll follow me, we can talk about the details.
Those dangerous foreigners. Moors go home. Anyway, it's my hope that they didn't change St. Lucia too much because then I'd have to play it again. See? 8. The perfect number of bits and stealth score. And if you'd like to see the second mission in the series, St. Lucia, which doesn't seem to necessarily carry over that much from this, but you know, it's a pretty cool mission, but I've played it already, so a link will be in the description. And other than that, see you guys next time. I'm bye for now.